Dragon's match with any degree of certainty, Mrs. Gilbert, but the day will come, I promise you that.
All right, well, let's meet these new candidates.
Well, you're the candidate, Mrs. Gilbert. The dogs need to meet you,
of course.
Rocco! Hey, you! Stop! Hey, Rocco! Excuse me. Fugitive on the loose. Yay, high response to the name of Rocco, apparently.
Carly?
Dan, hi.
I didn't know you were in town.
Yeah. Last week, I'm taking over my grandpa's clinic. Your sister wrote me and said you guys needed some help. But, seems I've lost my first patient already. Oh, excuse me. Sorry. Rocco!
Friend? Used to be. Are you ready for your interview?
Yeah.
Oh, hey there, little guy. They'll get you, little guy.
Thanks, Michelle. Man, you sure do run fast for having such short little legs. Okay, come on. Let's see why you're so upset.
Aw, well, that's why he's so sensitive. Poor little guy's got an ear infection, but I'm going to fix that right up.
Your grandpa must be so happy that you're back.
Oh, he is. So much so that he wants me to live at his house permanently. He has a place.
That's sweet. He's probably just lonely.
Yeah, you know, I keep trying to convince him to adopt one of these dogs.
Oh, well, you should set him up with my brother. After all, he is Dan the Dog Man.
Dan the Dog Man?
Everyone's favorite matchmaker? The canine connector?
Just wait. Yeah, no, I already ran into him. Literally.
That's fast.
Yeah. Hey, how come you didn't tell him I was the new volunteer veterinarian?
Oh, I don't know.
Michelle, what is high school? All right, let's listen to the old ticker. Come here. Wow. I mean, this is seriously probably the nicest shelter I've ever been in. How do you afford this?
Oh, we have a secret weapon.
A secret weapon?
We have a genuine TV star that does a weekly segment on the news. Brings in a lot of donations.
Oh. Oh my goodness, she is just the most adorable thing I have ever seen. Oh.
Oh, me Cujo.
Oh, no, I don't believe that. That couldn't possibly be true.
And even Dan can't find a match for her. Let's go.
Okay.
It's about to start.
About to start. What is all this?
Oh, welcome to Friday's Forever Friend weekly segment.
Oh, your secret weapon.
Oh, just wait.
We're live in 30 seconds. Where's our star?
She doesn't know it yet.
She?
Mm-hmm.
Right here. Makeup has to be right, people.
Oh, come on. Christine Waters, the queen of mean?
I told you you'd love it.
10 seconds.
She was always posing for a camera, even when there wasn't one.
And in five.
Oh, it gets four. Even better.
Hi, everyone. Time to meet Friday's Forever Friend. I'm here, as always, with Dan the Dogman Landis, the canine connector, at the Forever Friend shelter, where it's time to find the perfect match for you. So, Dan, just who is this adorable little girl we get to meet today?
Well, Christy, I'll agree that this puppy is very cute, but I gotta tell you, this girl is a guy, and his name is Bob.
Now, who names a puppy Bob?
Actually, my sister Michelle, and she named Bob's brother Stan, so I think they might grow up to be accountants.
Oh.
Oh, boy. Here, you wanna hold him?
Of course. Oh, Bob, you are the most gorgeous little guy ever.
Bob's here looking for someone who likes to play, and it's good enough to have Bob pick you, then Bob's adoption will be easy and affordable.
And that's why we love to show all the folks at home Friday's Forever Friend. I'll be back next week with Dan the Dog Man to introduce you to another lovable pooch looking for a forever home. For Channel 7 News, I'm Christy Waters saying, make man's best friend your best friend.
Clear!
Can somebody take this, please?
Here, I got him.
Wait, what? She hates dogs?
Yeah, it gets better.
I wish you wouldn't make me hold them like that. How many times do I have to tell you?
Sorry, but it works.
You're lucky. You're so dang cute.
What?
Yep.
Hey, Carly.
I'll take him.
Carly Monroe. Wow, you're exactly the same.
So are you.
I'll take that as a compliment.
So will I.
This is Christy Waters. Seriously? Yes. Yes, of course. Absolutely. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. I'm going to New York.
You got the job.
Yes. I can't believe it. It's actually happening. Oh, my head is spinning. They want me.
Welcome to the Christie Show.
Exactly. Well, not right away. I'll be a field reporter to start, but not for long. Oh, New York City.
Well, congratulate.
Come on, Dan the Dog Man. We are going out to celebrate.
Should I tell her the doggy made a messy on her shirt?
No.
Far, far away.
long days never work. You and Dan, of all people, should know that. Your timing is perfect.
My timing?
Mm-hmm. Michelle, I did not move back here to be with Dan. We're not in high school anymore.
You were,
like, all still in high school. It doesn't matter. You can deny it all you want, but there is a reason why you haven't fallen in love, gotten married, had kids, all of that. Why? No, it's not like that. Mm-hmm. No, Dan and I, we had something great. And then we went off to college. Life happened. You know what I think it is? I think it's just that I don't want to settle for anything less than how I felt for him. And that's it. That's all. That's end of story. All stories that I am happy with my life. Do not meddle.
No, I'm not. I'm not meddling.
You are a meddler. You always meddle.
I gotta go.
Do you want to come over tonight for dinner?
Okay, sure.
Yeah?
Cook up a little love pasta.
Would you stop?
All right, I'm going.
Dressed up for the occasion.
What occasion?
No, I'm gonna... How are you?
Well, it was meant as one.
Oh, no.
Four.
Four what?
Four plates.
Why four?
Yoo-hoo, hello.
You didn't.
She wanted to come.
Damn. Christy! Looking great.
Hello, everyone.
Hey.
So sweet of you to do this.
I mean, it's just dinner.
Oh, no, it's not. I mean, we could have gone to a nice restaurant or something, but this is very thoughtful. And honestly, unexpected. I didn't think you'd approve. Not that Dan needs your approval. You haven't even told her?
Tell me what?
Well, first, I'm needed in New York sooner than expected. Oh. We're moving at the end of the month.
Oh, I mean, you're moving at the end of the month.
No, we. Us together. And that's not the big news. The big news is we're getting married.
I haven't had a chance to tell you yet. We just decided this morning.
Decided?
Yeah.
You're getting married.
Yeah. It's exciting, huh?
Married! You can't move to New York.
Of course he can.
I mean, what about the shelter?
We'll figure something out.
Dan has bigger aspirations than running a dog shelter.
So do I. I was our agreement.
Well, our agreement was that if I got the network job and moved to New York, we'd get married.
How romantic.
We can talk about this tomorrow.
I mean, you can't leave.
Hey, it's gonna be all right, okay?
So, what's for dinner? I'm starved.
Bon appetit. He cannot leave.
He's going to marry her? This cannot happen.
She is so wrong for him.
He's going to be stuck with her for the rest of his life.
You have to change his mind.
Oh, come on, Michelle. You can't just change someone's mind about these things.
Do you want him to marry her?
Not exactly. Do you want the shelter to be shut down?
Trust me. Of course not.
We have 30 days to turn this disaster around.
Oh, and the meddling begins.
Oh, no. The countdown begins. It's on.
Well, your duck will be swimming again in no time, Mrs. Dunlap.
Oh, thanks, because she takes after me. Your granddaughter has a nice disposition. I don't know where she got that from.
Oh, very funny. But nonetheless, you're going to be in good hands when I retire.
You're never going to retire, Isaac. You know that. Well, take care now.
You too.
Come on.
She's right, you know. She was your calling. What is it?
I'm fine.
I heard that Dan was leaving. Getting married, is he?
Word travels fast, huh?
I don't think Dan and New York are a very good match, though, do you?
It's not really my business.
Oh?
Well, I mean, I'm worried about the shelter. You know, he does great work there, and there's a lot of dogs that wouldn't have homes if it wasn't for him.
I hate to see him make a mistake. What is it?
Michelle wants me to come in. One of the dogs is having an emergency, so I'll see you later.
You want me to go?
No, it's okay. I got it.
Okay.
I've already been looking at flight. The whole wedding thing is another issue. It's going to be everything I can do to keep my mother from taking over. You know how she is.
Well, I know.
It doesn't matter. We will decide what we want. I just cannot believe this is really happening. We're actually going to be living in New York.
What am I going to be doing there?
We'll find something for you, sweetie. Look, this is going to open up for both of us.
It's a big change, Christy. Michelle, she's not happy. It's putting her under a lot of pressure, too.
Michelle doesn't control your life. What?
It's nothing.
I want you to be excited about this.
I am excited, but I've got a lot of responsibilities here.
You always do. You have always been so supportive. And I want you with me. We're a team. And I love you. What now?
It's Michelle. Something's wrong with one of the...
I mean, she might as well get used to handling things, right?
It's beastly.
You know, that nasty thing?
She's not nasty. And I'm the only one that she trusts.
It's just a dog.
See you tomorrow. What's wrong with her?
It was the darndest thing. I heard whimpering, and then I went to check in on her, and she wasn't breathing. Then, like a miracle, just popped right back to normal before Carly got here.
Miracle, huh?
Yeah, she seems fine to me. I would check her. Uh-huh. I know how much Beasley means to you. Sorry, I hope it didn't panic you.
Yeah, she wasn't breathing, right?
Like I said, it was the darndest thing.
Yeah, you said that. What were you doing here at this hour anyway?
Well, I have to take over the shelter, so... I have a lot of work to do.
Right, right.
I'm gonna let you two. And, toodles! Well, it's a good thing she was here, huh?
Miracle.
Yeah.
Speaking of which...
What?
You seem to be the only other person Beasley's comfortable with.
Oh, really? What's her history?
We don't know. I found her in a ditch.
Oh.
I guess that's why she trusts me so much.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Oh, wait, she's wondering if she can take you for a walk.
Oh, wait, take me for a walk?
Yeah.
Well, yes, of course. I would love that. Would you like to join us?
I'll have to ask.
Oh.
Is that okay, Beasley?
I think that's a yes.
Definitely a yes.
Yeah. So, Dan the Dog Man, Mr. Expert Matchmaker. Come on, Beasley's clearly chosen who she wants to be with. Why haven't you adopted her?
That you're honest with me. The truth, the Friday friend thing, that was all Christy's idea. She made it happen. I was allowed to do what I love, save the shelter and a lot of animals, so... you know, I owe her for that.
Don't you mean you love her for that? Come on, Dan, we owe... bankers and lawyers, not fiancés.
You just don't know her the way that I know her.
No. Come on, I'm just looking out for you, kid.
Thanks, kid. Well, you know, I might take Beasley home with me tonight. It really helps to keep her calm, and I just slid around the corner.
Yeah, well, I gotta go back to the shelter and grab a few things, but I'll close up for you.
Thanks.
Hey, thank Beasley for the walk.
I will. Hey, Carly.
Yeah.
Thank you for the walk.
You're welcome.
Come on.
Oh, boy.
Hello. Hey there.
I know what we need to do.
Should I be nervous?
Well, what's your next brilliant plan?
You. Me?
It's pretty obvious, the way Dan looked at you last night. He lit up like a firefly. Not to mention, you absolutely glow around him.
I don't glow.
Point is, he's crushing. He just doesn't know it yet.
No, come on, that ship has sailed with the wind at Christie's back, right? Dan's never gonna see me the way that he sees Christie, and I mean that literally.
So, you agree?
Agree to what?
You need a tune-up.
What am I, a car?
A makeover. You know how men are. They're visual. You just have to bait the hook a little.
Bait the hook.
You're insane.
Insanity is the mother of invention.
Necessity is the mother of invention.
Exactly.
Listen, if Dan's not going to be with Christy, then he needs to figure that out on his own. Okay? Not because of your plotting.
Well, some things take plotting.
No. I am not going to be the bait to your scheming hook.
Then he's going to be gone.
Well, then he was meant to go.
No, this is not the time for your desperate times. Call for desperate...
3 words for you. No way.
It's 4 words. Anyways, you have to trust me on this.
I don't trust you on anything. Listen, I have a ton of patience in the morning, so I'm going to need you to go, right?
I just got here.
I think you need to go find somewhere else to meddle.
Oh, I don't meddle.
I don't think you know what that word means.
I've never meddled before. I'm really sorry I haven't been able to make a decision yet, Dan.
Well, you don't choose the dog, Mrs. Gilbert.
The dog chooses me, I know that. But it still has to be mutual, and I just haven't... So are you getting tired of setting up all of my interviews?
Hey, not at all. Okay, when you know, you'll know. And so will he or she. It's a lot like falling in love. You can't control it, it controls you.
Are you an expert at falling in love?
Far from it. Well, as anyone.
Actually, yes, Mike, in that way. I miss him, and I guess that's why I'm looking for a friend.
Well, then let's make sure we find you the right match, shall we?
Yeah.
Well, I got my license in that.
No.
No, I got my braces off in that. It was a really big day. It's cute. No, no! Look, I can't afford a whole new wardrobe, okay? I have student loans to pay off.
And I
have a...
Interested in a new companion, and he'd like to take you for a walk, Dr. Monroe. I'm
glad to hear it.
Thanks, Megan.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
All right, so just be yourself. Don't try to impress. Dogs see truth.
I've been a vet for over 50 years, Dan.
You told me noon.
I'm afraid I did, Mrs. Gilbert. I am so sorry for the mix-up.
There are other dogs.
Do you have any idea how long it has taken me to find a dog that I can actually...
Wait. Prince might have a solution. He'd like to take both of you for a walk. That's okay.
All right.
I suppose.
Where should we go?
There's a nice little trail right around the corner.
Well, I think Prince would like that.
He does. Really?
All right, I suggest you both be on your best behavior. Prince here is very particular and frowns on anything but happy thoughts. Understood?
Understood.
Thank you.
Take some time, you know, get to know each other.
Patient here, huh?
Beasley?
Oh, hey. Hey, you recognize me? It's Carly.
Maybe if you pulled your hair back, she could see your face better.
Right. My hair ties are in my purse.
Oh, your purse is in your car.
Right.
Rubber band.
Oh, I can...
Oh,
okay.
All right.
Thanks.
You look nice. I haven't seen you this dressed up since, prom.
Oh, you know, I thought I'd switch things up a little. So, let's see here. Okay. Let's see your pretty smile. There we go. Oh, that's a happy dog. Hey.
Yeah. You know, I used to bring my Charlie to you.
You know, I thought you looked familiar. Shepherd, right?
Yeah.
Beautiful animal.
Yeah. I met your wife once. And what was her name?
Claire. Well, I'm a widower now.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's all right. It's been a while. And your husband?
He's passed away as well. It's been a few years. Oh, listen, I'm sorry we got off on the wrong foot today. It's just that this is the first dog I've actually felt a connection. I think it's your turn to take the reins.
Well, let's both get to know him a little better.
Come on, buddy.
Talked her into it. Just change things up a little.
Why?
Yeah, I love you, but you really are.
Sweet tooth?
She does like chocolate.
Oh, I bet she does, but I don't think Chocolate likes her very much. How much chocolate did you give her, exactly?
Just a little. At best.
Gotta think of Sprinkles kind of like your little sister. I mean, she can only eat what she's supposed to, okay? You wouldn't stuff your little sister full of chocolate now, would you?
Maybe.
Oh. Well, next time, how about you just share your chocolate with me instead? She's good to go.
Thank you, Doctor.
Sure. Let me know if she breaks into another stash.
Will do.
Goodbye, thanks, Dr. Crowley.
Bye, Emma. Hi.
Hey. Why, I hardly recognize you with your contacts in.
Oh, very funny.
Peace offering.
Come on, I'm the one who should be offering peace terms.
You've all worn the wrong heels at the wrong occasion.
Ha-ha.
Bag lunch just like old times?
I don't know. Is it peanut butter and jelly?
Of course.
Okay, I accept your terms.
Excellent. For me, it was right here. With you.
Yes! Nicely done.
Hey, Monroe. $5 says you can't hit that shot.
Oh, come on, it's right there. I'm not that unathletic.
Okay, mm-hmm.
Make it 10.
You're on.
Okay. I'm about to make $10.
No pressure.
Oh, come on, pay up.
I forgot my wallet.
You were such a liar. Don't be a squelch. Oh, hello, Mr. Hamilton. Nice to meet you.
Let's go. I'd like to shot.
A total fool of myself, or just sort of?
Oh, no. It was total.
Come on.
But I know why you did it, I think. And I know that my sister put you up to it. Playing matchmaker, so maybe I wouldn't move.
Shouldn't exactly have to twist my arm.
Why exactly did you do it?
It doesn't really matter. You don't want to make.
And that's it? That's your only motive?
I guess I thought maybe, for a minute, that if I was as pretty as Christy, then maybe you would have second thoughts. It was stupid.
Yeah, it was.
Come on, you don't have to be that honest.
What I care about is how Christy looks, her job, her fame. And I'll let you in on a little secret. You don't need all those things to be prettier than Christy.
The part where you pass me a note and you ask me to be your girlfriend and tell me to circle yes or no?
I'm being serious.
Well, then don't tease me.
I'm not. Carly, you are beautiful. Glasses or no glasses. The truth is, seeing you again, it just brought me right back to us.
Listen, I got caught up in the moment, and it was silly, and I'm over it.
Over it? Oh. It really makes me wish I never went away to college.
Oh, come on, don't do that. Don't make regrets out of the choices you made.
But you don't think it was a mistake that we both left?
No. Because if it was a mistake, then it invalidates every choice we've ever made. Did I think about you? Did I sometimes wonder what might have been? Yes. But you're Dan the Dog Man. Your path took you here, and the world's a better place because of it. I followed my dreams. Now I'm a veterinarian, and the world's a better place because of that, too. Everything happens the way it's supposed to. So, no regrets.
You still believe in all that?
Yeah, all of it.
You think I'm making a mistake now, don't you?
No, you're making a choice, Dan. It's only a mistake if it's not your own. Hey, Michelle. Yeah, hang on.
Shoot, what time is it? Yeah, no, be right there. Come on.
Hey,
sorry, my phone died.
With her? It's 4 o'clock, Dan.
I know, I lost track of time.
Listen, it was my fault. I was enjoying his company.
I'm sure you were. While you two were out gallivanting, no one here can make a decision. They don't know what dog you want to feature.
We just didn't know which dog was ready to be matched yet.
We have no dog for the segment, and we go on air in 3 minutes.
Speckles.
Oh, I'll get him.
But go, go! Catching up on old times?
Yeah.
I don't like the way she speaks to me, or looks at me.
She probably feels the same way.
Oh, so it's my fault?
One minute!
We need a dog now.
Come on, Prince.
There. That one. Excuse me. We are going to need to borrow this dog.
For what?
Friday's friend segment. Sort of have an emergency situation.
30 seconds!
Oh, no, no, no. This is ours. You're going to have to find another dog.
You'll find another dog.
No.
We are about to go live.
Prince already made his decision.
Which one of us did he pick?
Seriously?
I think you both know me.
You are a very rude young lady.
Excuse me?
They got him.
Oh, Carly to the rescue.
I hope so.
All right, and in 3, 2.
For Channel 7 News, I'm Christy Waters with Dan the Dog Man saying, make man's best friend your best friend.
Clear!
Great job. Beautifully done.
Thank you, and my apologies. Just don't think any of you realize the pressure of performing on live TV. Could I get some water, please?
So, how's the extended interview process?
Bad, then.
Impeccable.
I know I go on and on about the shelter, but
he's my brother, and I kind of like having him there. I got used to it.
So you're just giving up? Yeah, I mean, Dan just got his dream job. Our little plan backfired. Just wave the white flag.
I'm not. I have an idea.
Talk to me.
The only problem is, I still have urns of memories.
Are you deep in thought again?
You have to understand something, Michelle. We don't remember past relationships based on fact. We remember them based on feelings, you know? Just grasp onto something that can never be recreated, and by romanticizing certain experiences, we simply make our present fulfillment of life seem worse than it actually is.
Come again?
I also have to make sure that I'm doing the right thing, so...
Okay, fine.
Okay, so Dan's main concern about leaving is the welfare of the dogs, right?
Right, seems to be the case.
And so what if we have an adoption fair? I mean, forget about adopting one dog. What if we find homes for all of them before Dan leaves?
That's great, the dogs, yay. But what about you and Dan and keeping him here? I mean, that's just going to make him happy that he's leaving.
Well, not necessarily. I mean, maybe it'll make him realize what wonderful work he's doing me from. Besides, it'll give us a chance to spend some more time together.
Really use some more time.
Uh-huh. To convince Dan?
Or you?
Both.
There we go. Just keep an eye on him. He'll be okay.
Come on, buddy.
You didn't steal him, did you?
Yeah, I stole him.
Oh?
Actually, I thought maybe you might like to take him for a walk on your own property. Give him a chance to see if he likes it here or not before he makes his decision.
Stay with you. You think Prince would like it here?
I think he'd love it.
You know, if I did adopt him, you could come and visit him anytime.
Oh?
Well, I mean, we gotta do what's right for the dog.
You know, your flowers are so beautiful. Did you plant all these yourself?
It's become somewhat...
If you decide to retire, you're going to need a hobby. Oh,
not if. Carly's more than capable. Her patients will be in good hands.
You know, she is so lovely. And it's just a shame that Dan's moving away because the two of them are in love. They seem to be the only two that don't know it.
I think they do. They just don't know how to say it.
Well, I hope they figure it out.
Shame if they don't.
I think it's perfect. You think we can get it organized in a week?
We can do it.
Yeah, we can do it. We'll just, pass out some flyers, hang up some posters, and, we'll make it an event.
Where are we going to hold it?
Well, it shouldn't be here. It should be someplace people would normally take their dogs. How about Long Lake Park? Do a meet and greet, have some fun. We could do an interview room.
I love it.
Great.
Oh, and I thought a banner that says Countdown to Love. Just to remind people that dogs are more than just pets.
Oh, hey, Bees. You doing okay?
Huh? Yeah, let's just call it what it is.
Okay, yeah. Let's do it. I just really want you to know I really appreciate everything you're doing. And oh shoot. Sorry. Hey, what's up? Because if I'm gonna work for them, then I should
Beasley.
Introduce myself.
Come here.
Okay, yeah. Sure. See you soon. I'm gonna have to catch up with you. I gotta go help Christy pack.
Yeah, well, I gotta give Beasley another checkup anyway.
It is just so amazing how she has taken to you.
Yeah, she just needed a little more time.
Isn't it amazing how much she loves dogs? I mean, she's a real dog person. What? I'm just saying. Right, we'll see you there. So I've got all the shelter volunteers on board with helping with the event.
Local media is going to promote it, and they are eating up the Countdown to Love idea.
That's great. What next?
Print shop. Oh, and tomorrow we have to work on getting all these critters cleaned up, so can you get some supplies for that?
I'm already on it.
Great. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Forever Friends Rescue Shelter, Michelle speaking.
Rita came over to discuss Prince.
Oh, Rita.
We were just talking about...
Discussing Prince.
Clearly.
Come sit down. Actually, we've made a decision about Prince.
And who gets to adopt him?
Dan seems to think he likes both of us.
Equally.
I see.
We decided that we would...
We both actually like to spend a lot more time with him. Actually, about as much time as possible.
Okay.
And the only logical way to do that is if we both adopt him.
Very logical.
Yeah, which means we would be spending a lot of time together.
Well, I think that's great.
You do?
Really?
Yeah. Of course I do. I you both deserve a...
About Prince.
Mm-hmm, definitely, and it's very noble.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, I saw a cute little apartment for rent just down the street.
Great, Bob. Okay, I'll look into it. I think... Okay. You don't think this is moving a little fast, do you? For Prince?
Well, at our age, we have to move fast.
Have a good night.
Whoa. Yeah, so, I just was so close with my grandfather, and I just thought that it made sense for me to want to become a veterinarian,
Yeah.
This was so cute.
I know, it's been so good today, too. Gotta get them clean. Nobody likes a smelly dog, do they? I was thinking about Beasley here. And you know that I'm a good matchmaker.
Oh yeah, the best. A legend. What do they call you in these parts? The canine connector?
Well, that's one of them. Anyhow, I was thinking
that I should adopt Beasley.
Well, actually, that Beasley should adopt you. You're the only other person that she trusts. And I'm not holding on to a lot of hope that that's going to change after the adoption fair. I'm just really worried about what's going to happen to her after I leave.
Hey, come on, Beasley's great, but she belongs with you.
Yeah, it's non-negotiable.
pretty amazing to me how you can be so good at matching dogs to people and even people. My grandfather hasn't been this happy in years. Very cleverly done, by the way.
It was a layup.
Yeah, but still, you did that. And you do it every day, but somehow you really have no talent for matching yourself to others, do you?
You know, every discussion we have is about my choices and my decisions. What about you? Tell me how you really feel.
Okay. Don't go to New York. That's how I feel.
No, that's what you think. Why don't you want me to go to New York?
Come on. Because, Dan, her timing is impeccable.
So is yours.
Figures you two would be in a dog-friendly cafe. Are you having another stroll down memory lane?
We were just discussing my future in New York. How much I'm gonna miss Beasley.
Beasley?
Yeah.
Well, thanks to me, Beasley will more than likely have a new home by tomorrow. I spoke with my station manager. They've agreed to do live updates from the adoption fair throughout the day. Sort of an extension of the Friday Friends segment. There won't be a single dog left with that kind of exposure.
And then there will be nothing holding Dan back?
Exactly.
You know, Christy, you have an uncanny ability of somehow manage to serve you more than anyone.
Thank you. Dan, we're having dinner with my parents, remember? Are you coming with me?
Are you?
Yeah. Yeah.
On each other, but they'd never say anything about it, and I think they were too embarrassed, but yet they always seemed to find some reason to...
Walking the same dog, Mrs. Gilbert.
Yeah. I think I've been playing along quite nicely, don't you?
Oh yes, very, very nicely.
I mean, men are clueless sometimes. I mean that in the most loving way. It's really quite sweet. And then, of course, there's Dan. He's so proud of his matchmaking skills, and I don't want him to be disappointed. But he did kind of make sure that I was at the show. I came to walk the dog. Your grandpa's kind of hot.
Oh, Mrs. Gilbert.
No, seriously, it's hot.
Stop.
You know, women don't pick up on things the way we do, Dan. That's why I had to play along, you know, and just to act like I didn't know he was more than Prince he wanted to take a walk with.
So you're onto her?
Of course I am. She doesn't realize that. And don't tell her. I don't want to embarrass her.
Says an old dog can't learn new tricks.
Says I'm an old dog.
it's so obvious how you two feel about each other. Just say it.
Your grandfather's telling me everything I need to know without ever saying a word.
Sometimes you need to say words, Mrs. Gilbert. Sometimes you need to hear them.
Do you see that on a pillow or a sign?
A sign, actually. But the point is, the two of you didn't just find the perfect dog. You found each other. Seize the day, remember?
I guess I should be taking my own advice.
Hey, you said it, not me.
You want me to tell her how I feel?
Women, they want to hear what's in your heart. You don't want her to meet another dog. Start taking him for a walk.
No, I suppose not.
So I think we're finished here.
Us too?
Good, let's go find Prince and we'll take him for a walk.
Great. Did you say I haven't told you how I felt?
Huh, you?
Oh, yeah.
Fingers crossed.
I'm so happy for them.
Me too.
No, it's funny. I know Mrs. Gilbert has more life experience than I do, but I think I was able to give her some really good advice.
Yeah, me too.
Hope they clue in.
Me too. Look, Boing and I'm leaving you at the shelter. What?
No, I'm not anymore. I mean it. I just don't want you to be stressed out anymore. You know, I just want you to know that the shelter is in good hands. I just hope that you are.
I guess that's the million-dollar question, hey? Maybe. Carly coming home brought back a lot of memories, a lot of feelings. Good ones. And then suddenly I have to move, give up the shelter that I worked so hard to build, make decisions on the rest of my life. I'm feeling torn. And I can't help but wonder if that's for us of how I used to feel. And maybe it's the same for her and she just doesn't realize it yet.
Wow. You both are seriously attached to the brain. Look, you don't need any more advice. Especially from me. I mean, you're my brother. I love you. No matter what you decide, I'm going to support you. But I will say this. Sometimes it's not a decision. The universe decides these things for us. Just hope that you'll be awake enough to get the clue. Brother.
They find their perfect match. You.
Because that's what Dan the Dogman does. Come see him while you still can, because tomorrow we'll be taking off for New York, New York. Keep watching. We'll be back with one and cut.
We have officially been adopted.
That's great. The both of you?
Well, officially it's in Rita's name, but I get visitation rights.
It's joint custody.
Great event, Carly. You should be proud of yourself.
Thanks, Grandpa.
We're going to dinner later at the Grill House.
Why don't you join us?
No, actually, I need to stay back at 3. Enjoy yourselves.
See you at the house?
Yeah. Bye. Bye. Have fun. Oh, how cute are they? They're adorable. So glad they finally figured it out.
Hey, I can't even begin to tell you how amazing this is.
Yeah, I didn't think this many people would turn out.
One of the things I'm going to do when I get to New York is sponsor events like this throughout the pet stores. There are so many shelters with animals just waiting for someone to give them a home.
Yeah, I think that's a great idea. You know, Dan, actually, I'm pretty worried about Beasley. You know, she's been really agitated. She's snarling at everyone.
Maybe we should keep her with one of us.
Yeah. Hey, we want to get Beasley. Come here.
Hey, Bees.
Alrighty. See? She just needed some fresh air and sunshine, huh?
See? You're a good match.
Yeah.
Oh, finally. It's about my job. I've been calling and calling, and they're only now just getting back to me.
Yeah, go.
Dan here.
How's it going? Well, we continue to talk in metaphors. We don't have time for metaphors. Who's he talking to on the phone? It's about his job. Well, he doesn't look happy.
Where is Dan? We are about to go live.
He's over there.
Uh-oh. What? Why uh-oh? Be right back. We're on there in 3 minutes, babe.
That was my new boss.
Oh?
Regional executive director? That job is filled and it's not vacating anytime soon. They want me on as a volunteer.
Okay, I know how this sounds. I may have made a slight error in my choice of words.
Choice of words? You said I was going to be the regional executive director.
Which is sticks? Once you get in there, once you wow them, you'll go right to the top. What I said is, you will be the regional executive director. One day.
He looks pretty upset.
You manipulated me.
I had to do something. Otherwise, you wouldn't come with me. Look, I am doing you a favor by getting you out of this.
Lying to me?
Well, I'm not the only one who lied to you.
What are you talking about?
Carly? Yes, she's been lying to you for weeks.
I think I just heard your name. My name?
Yeah. Oh, come on. Anyone could see right through it. The way she's been playing you, trying to make you think she's still in love with you, just so you would stay in...
She wasn't playing me.
Well, see? It worked.
How bad? And the last time I saw Christy this worked up was when that 5-year-old crashed her live shot and she threw an ice cream cone at him. I don't know what we're gonna do. Oh, you! You're on.
What do you mean I'm on?
We're going live, unless you want to go deal with that.
No, I don't. No, I can't.
You're cute. Here, do it for the dogs.
What? You're already holding one.
Yeah, you're a vet, right?
Yeah?
Yeah. Just look at the camera, smile, you'll be fine.
Love you!
And in 5, 4... We're live.
Hi. Everyone. I'm Carly. I'm a veterinarian who volunteers at the Forever Friend shelter. Christy and Dan are currently predisposed with some other dog business.
She doesn't even like that dog.
Sorry?
That dog you're so in love with that hates everyone?
Carly adores Beasley.
Please. Nobody adores. Carly's just telling you what you want to hear. Look, she comes back after all these years, expects you to drop everything for her. Who's manipulating who? Huh?
Hey, listen, we just wanted to thank everyone for making this such a successful event and get down here before your potential forever friend gets fetched up by someone else.
I thought we were a team. What is she doing?
Wait, it's live.
Anyway, there's still one very special dog that hasn't found someone to love yet. Her name is Beasley. See, dogs are special, but there's just something about the unconditional love of a dog that makes the world a better place. And they're a lot like us. Some are tall, some are short, some are less friendly than others. Some are more trusting, caring. And like us, they just want someone to come home to know that they have someone who will greet them,
to know that they have a friend. Sometimes they actually do wish that things turned out differently, despite what they may have said. Or barked. The thing about Beasley here is that she's independent, and I think sometimes she worries that she'll lose that, so she tends to withdraw and close herself off. But she only does it because she's scared. She's scared that all those things that I just talked about, that she wants too, she'll never have them. I don't think that she needs to be afraid anymore. Because her path brought her here, to this exact moment. And there's nowhere else she'd rather be. Those of you who know Dan the Dog Man know what he says. That we don't the dog chooses us. And you see, I got up here today to help find this girl a new home, but the truth is I can't do that because Beasley chose Dan. And she really wants him to stay. Because she loves him.
I always will.